In today's video, we'll give you a hands-on demonstration of integrating multiple industry-leading LLMs, like from OpenAI and Google, into a single chatbot application. Through the framework that we will present, you'll have the capability to very easily add other new models to your system. For instance, you could enrich and empower your custom chatbot with models like Anthropic's Claude. The real trick here is our approach of leveraging the abstractions provided by LangChain. This will keep things really simple and make our platform portable across different LLM API providers. How do we actually build our custom chatbot? Well, we'll do that with Python code and specifically the Flask framework. If you've never even heard of Flask before, don't stress. We're only talking about a couple dozen lines of code, and the concepts are highly portable to other web frameworks. Our demonstration will focus on showcasing each response from the configured AI models for each user prompt. This could be useful if, for example, you want to easily compare and contrast responses across the LLM providers in a simple, unified web frontend. However, there are, of course, other use cases, such as synthesizing multiple responses across your different models or incorporating a filtering, scoring, or selection mechanism to choose the best answers across your models. The approach that we highlight today can be tuned to a wide variety of use cases like this. Take note, our custom Python web app will also need to manage chat sessions across these different models, which is facilitated but not entirely handled by LangChain. Rest assured, despite the complexities, we'll keep things simple. The entire setup is only about 100 lines of code. And as a bonus, we'll provide you with a Docker file so you can readily operationalize your app on platforms like Amazon's EC2, Google Cloud Run, or even non-cloud systems. Anywhere that runs Docker, you'll be able to deploy your custom chatbot. Just bear in mind the additional networking and security that's often required. As usual, we'll provide all the code for this demonstration as well as the diagram file in the description below this video. Now, let's dive right in. We don't need much to kick things off. All we're going to do initially is navigate to Vertex AI and enable all the recommended APIs. This will enable the PaLM2 model for our web app. Beyond that, we just need an OpenAI API key if you've opted to use that model as well. Once the API is enabled, let's move on to our code setup. First off, we need a source code file for our Flask Python app. This code will detail the LangChain-based approach for handling multiple chat sessions. We'll import the LangChain chat models for OpenAI and Google Cloud's Vertex AI, but we can just as smoothly import other models like Chat Anthropic. After initializing these models, there'll be some Flask code for routing and handling API requests. Calls to the root directory will present our front-end code in an index.html file. Meanwhile, if we hit the API for chatbot requests, we'll use the Google and OpenAI models to get a response. A slightly tricky part here is maintaining state. For our chat models to have a consistent and evolving engagement, we need to keep track of chat sessions from previous interactions. For this, we'll use a session ID cookie stored in the user's browser. With this, we'll keep the conversation grounded with context from previous messages. To maintain these multiple AI model conversations simultaneously, we'll use a chat sessions variable, which will store all our sessions in memory. Note that if you reboot the dev server, or if you restart the application's Docker container, you may lose previous chat history and context. If you need a more production-grade session caching system, consider using external files or databases for session caching. Next up, we'll take the input from the body of the request and use it to run chatbot requests to all the configured models. Upon doing so, we'll return the response and ensure that our user is correctly set up with the session ID cookie. Lastly, we have some basic code for a development server that'll run, for instance, on port 8080. Essentially, we're using LangChain as an abstraction mechanism and routing all chat prompts to both AI models. We're gathering responses and maintaining statefulness using in-memory session handling. Next up, let's ensure all Python packages needed for this project are installed locally using a requirements-based install command. The Docker image uses the same requirements file, but we'll run things locally for simplicity. Moving forward, let's focus on creating the front-end file for our web application. We'll utilize a single HTML file, which also contains our CSS and JavaScript. Although it's common to separate these for more complex projects with intricate styling or logic, a single file will work perfectly for us. Our front-end setup will feature a chat box for messaging, as well as an input interface to capture user prompts, which can be dispatched with a button press. Various JavaScript functions run this front-end, including an append message function, which inserts specific messages into our chat box and uses varied background colors to differentiate responses from the various LLMs. Our send message function, although short, holds the core logic for our front-end. Once the send button is pressed, an API call is triggered to our Python Flask API carrying the user's message in the request's body. Upon receiving a successful response, we will mirror the user's input as a message in the chat box and subsequently append responses from our Google and OpenAI models. To incorporate more models in this front end, simply insert more append message code. For instance, to integrate the Anthropic model, designate a background color and retrieve its data from the API. Subsequently, on the back end, import the chat model and initiate it in our service. Ensure it's part of our chat sessions and is called during API requests. To retain simplicity, let's sideline the third model for now. Time to test drive our new application. If you're using the Google Cloud Shell IDE like us, the authentication with Vertex AI is already sorted. However, if you're using a different IDE, perhaps running locally on your laptop, run a gcloud init command, or activate an appropriate service account. You'll also need an authentication setup for the OpenAI model, so don't forget to export your OpenAI key. Follow the authentication process for any additional models. For instance, the Anthropic model would need an environment variable for your Anthropic API key. If you productionalize with the provided Docker file, make sure your deployment environment also has the required environment variables. After sorting out authentication, let's kickstart our application. We'll then run our web preview server from the Cloud Shell. Now our front-end interface for our chatbot is ready. Let's take it for a spin to ensure everything runs as intended. Looking at results, we can see responses from both our models. Great! We'll let you be the judge of which model is the better comedian here. To prove that we have a functioning persistent chat session, let's continue within this context to see if these models can explain their jokes. Indeed, we do have that context carrying over. For instance, Google is discussing the Turing test here and seems to be explaining the underlying concepts from the joke. OpenAI, on the other hand, is explaining the joke itself. In any case, we do have well-functioning sessions. To assist your extension, revision, or reuse of this architecture, we'll include all the code from today, as well as the diagram file, in a GitHub repository. Also, we've decided to complement this AI tutorial video with an AI safety donation program. As long as this video is still up, we're donating $1 to the Center for AI Safety for every 10 new subscribers. Together, we can help your AI projects, help the channel, and help the great folks working on critical AI safety research. We'll keep an eye on the comment section for any questions. Thank you very much for watching, and please enjoy responsibly.